Hello, beautiful people. How are you doing today? I hope we are still moving on fine. We are still on a Sunday, the 10th day in the month of May 2020. My time here is 7:23 in the evening. So wherever you are, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Depends on your location at this time. All right, remember the story sometimes ago? Well, I didn't give the story, okay? I didn't make the story because I couldn't verify the authenticity of that story. So I'm always I try as much as possible, okay, not to give you guys a fake information. All right, so I couldn't verify that story, so that was why I didn't bring it up. So sometimes ago, there was a story, and it goes around the media that the Arewa Youth Consultative Forum, okay, threatened war against the people of the Southeast in the North because during this lockdown and interstate restriction, we have been seeing a lot of people from the North, okay, trooping in. I don't know, should I say trooping or running to the southern part of Nigeria, even during this interstate lockdown by the president. So sometimes most of the governors in this state have to return them back, okay? They are not arrested, okay? None of them is arrested. The only thing they do is to return back the vehicle, return them back from wherever they were coming from. So during that period, there was this report that the Alhaji Yerima Shetima from that is the national president of Arewa Youth threatens war against the people of the Southeast in the North, okay, because the Southeast governors is not allowing their people their freedom of movement, okay, to go to wherever they are in Nigeria, that they are also Nigerians, they have the right to move from one place to another, all right, and threaten war against the people of the Southeast. But so far, Alhaji Yerima Shetima have denied the report, okay? So like I said, I didn't want to give you the story because I did not verify the story, okay? So he have denied the report, which link him to the threat of war against the people of the Southeast in the North. So we urge Nigerians to disregard the shadowy group of troublemakers who assume they could use either his name or his group to destabilize the nation. All right. So Shetima also reiterated that the threat of war was not and can never be his style as a progressive and modern Democrat, adding that the beliefs that he believes in the spirit of consultation as a strategy for achieving their noble objective as a people. All right, so let me quickly give the statement from Yerima Shetima. Okay, so the statement says, my attention has been drawn to a fake breaking news in which some unknown mischief makers struggle to connect me to the threat against the people of the Southeast over a purported threat to northern youth in the zone. The so-called news was the handiwork of some unknown rabble-rouser designed to dent the public image of struggle I have built for decades. I bet this shadowy group that their evil agenda is dead on arrival, as Nigerians are now too sophisticated to believe that kind of trash being willy-nilly tied to my name and my group. However, I would like to make it categorically clear that much as the purported trade of war was not my style, this does not mean I no longer care about my northern brothers. I still have the northern youth at heart and will strive to promote and protect their interests peacefully and in line with legal and constitutional provision. I urge Nigerians of good conscience to continue to disregard this shadowy group of troublemakers who assume they could either use my name or that of my group to destabilize the nation. I wish to reiterate that the threat of war is not and can never be my lifestyle. As a progressive and modern Democrat, I believe wholeheartedly in the spirit of consultation as a strategy for achieving a noble objective as people. So he expressed gratitude to who reached out to him to express concern over this devilish plot, and to give him extra courage to always legitimately stand on the side of the North, okay, and of truth. So according to him, he also added that I cannot thank you enough for the massive solidarity. All right. So let me know what you think on the comment section below. Like I said, I didn't want to give you the story because I couldn't verify it. But now Shettima has denied the claim, the threat of war, okay, by the Arewa youth over their refusal by different state government to allow them entry to the southern or the southeast part of Nigeria. All right, but what worries me so much, all right, we have a restriction of interstate movement by the president. I really don't know why these guys, you know, keep moving, you know, keep smuggling themselves, okay, keep smuggling themselves or trying to smuggle themselves into the southern part of Nigeria. We are fighting pandemic already. This pandemic have climbed to the third stage of community spread. It has climbed to the third stage of community spread. Everybody should be conscious. Stay at home. All right, stay at home, stay in your house, observe yourself. Why move around? No place is safe in Nigeria anymore. I believe the two states that is coronavirus free so far is the Kogi state and the Cross River state. All right, so no way is safe. Everybody is trying everything humanly possible to make sure they keep their people safe. And Governor Wike, okay, the governor of River State, it's not taking this battle, not taking the battle of COVID-19. So likely he's treating it with a strong hand. Okay, today he have demolished two hotels in River State, one in Eleme, one in One. Okay, like the one in One, Temete Hotel, I think is in FLT after Intel's. Okay, the hotel is in FLT. When you cross Intel's, okay, that is FOT. So Wike is not taking the fight against this coronavirus likely. All right, so everybody should observe isolation. That is just the truth. But people in the North, Amajiri, they are trying to smuggle. I don't even know who is trying to smuggle them into the southern part of Nigeria, or if they are the one trying to smuggle themselves. Where are they running to? Where are you running to, for Christ's sake? And in Kaduna State, I almost 20-something Amajiri that went to Kaduna State tested positive of COVID-19. So imagine if those people were to, you know, teleport themselves or smuggle themselves into the southeast or the south part of Nigeria. Imagine the havoc it will cause. Yes, imagine the havoc it will cause. 25 in Kaduna Amajiri testing positive of COVID-19. So why not stay in your area? Why not stay in your state? No place is safe. All right. So that is the update I quickly wanted to give you guys from Shettima, okay, the national president of Arewa Youth Consultative Forum, denying the claim that linked to him, okay, to the threat of war against the people of the southeast in Nigeria. All right, let me know what you all have to contribute on the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe if this is your first time of watching any of our story. It is a part of your effort to support us to keep doing what we are doing. All right, see you in another video.